Well, the cost of gas, food, and medical care just keeps going up, and some of the hardest hit are seniors with a lot less money on hand.
Paul Franklin, President and CEO of Franklin Funding, joins us with more on traditional solutions as well as increasingly popular solutions from good old Uncle Sam. We want to welcome Paul. Good to see you, Paul.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Now, this is really tough because by the time seniors are ready to sit back and relax, they're running out of money. Do you find that quite a bit?
Yes, especially we all know, of course, about the high cost of gasoline and food prices, of course, are really going way up.
Right.
We also have the problem of medication for seniors, and that's going up, as well as all the medical technology is very expensive today.
For sure.
So what's happening in many cases, seniors are taking out another loan on their home, and they've got monthly payments on that, and so that just compounds the problem even more. So it's a very tough time for seniors, especially because they don't have the benefit of a job where they're going to get maybe a pay increase.
Right.
And many of them don't have the savings to help buffer some of those costs as well.
Yeah, it really is. Everything is getting more expensive. And you're talking a lot about medication. You don't know what's going to be wrong with you later in life. So you put aside a certain amount of money thinking that will cover it, but it doesn't seem like it's. How do you know what's enough?
Well, it's very difficult to predict. And I would say that most people probably haven't saved enough.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a big problem. They never thought prices were going to be the way they are today.
But you do have some solutions for seniors. And what are some of the steps that they can take right now to help with their financial situation?
What we find is most of our clients come to us, they've really tried a two-prong attack. One is there something they can do to increase their income? So they sell off maybe boats or cars or a lot that they're not using.
Right.
Some of them selling off life insurance that they no longer need. Some are even taking on part-time jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And others are looking at their savings and can they put it someplace else and earn a higher interest rate. So those are some of the things on the income side. On the expense side, of course, everybody's looking at ways to cut back on expenses. Can I reduce that trip to the grocery store or to the doctor's office or whatever? What can I cut out? And then, of course, there are other expenses like, can I restructure my loan that I have on my house right now so that I get a lower interest rate and lower those payments? So all of those are techniques that people are using, both on the income side and the expense side.
Now, Paul, do you find folks a lot of times when you grow older, you have this big house where you had kids one day and then you don't need that huge house anymore. Do you find folks selling their house and moving into smaller places?
Yes, that's certainly something that we recommend many times. Sometimes they've just outgrown the house. The house is too big. A lot of times the husband loves it because he's got his tools back in this wonderful little place, you know, and the wife is sitting there rolling her eyes. She says, I don't want to take care of this big house anymore.
Right.
So we suggest many times that they downsize. And one of the things that people can do if they don't want to do that, let's say a lot of our clients want to just age in place. And they want to stay in their home as long as possible. So for them, what is a good solution is the federal government has a plan strictly for senior homeowners, and it's called a home equity conversion mortgage, better known as a reverse mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
Has a wonderful, all kinds of senior protection features to it, where you have to go to a HUD housing counselor and get briefed on how this program works and get a certificate of counseling from the HUD housing counselor. There are controls on the cost of these. The government controls the interest rate. They control the origination fees and the fees that are attached to it. So lots of safeguards for seniors. The beauty of it is that they never have to pay it back as long as they live in the home.
Oh, wow.
So you don't have a monthly mortgage payment, and yet they still own their home. They have the title to it. Title doesn't change.
So all kinds of good solutions. How do we get a hold of you real quick? We're about to wrap up here.
Franklin Funding, 762-2218.
Sounds great.
And we also have a website.
Okay.
And that's www.franklin-funding.com.
Great information. Thanks so much, Paul.
Thanks.